Alright, so hey everyone, wait a minute. This is iPhone 6s Plus. I mean, this is the reason why you are here in the first place. So, this won't be any long-term review or something like that, but this will be a basic video whether you should be buying the 6s Plus in 2020 or not. I mean, I am thinking that the main reason you're gonna buy the iPhone 6s Plus right now will be something like your friend is selling that to you, or you wanna enter into the iOS realm but just keeping that budget a little. So let's get started by talking about the phone right away. The design of the phone is so much outdated because this is a phone from 2015 or 14. I haven't checked the stats yet. Wait, because this is a phone from September 2015. Now this design is so much outdated. This has been the same design in the iPhone 7, 7 Plus, 8 and 8 Plus before the iPhone 10 came out. So the design is so much disappointing. Now if you're someone who doesn't care about the design and you are okay with this huge bezels even in 2020, then go with it. You won't be having any problem with the display. Coming to the display, so this is a beautiful display yet made by Samsung. Yes, all the iPhone displays are made by Samsung and this is no exception. This is a beautiful display and the touch response on it is great. I mean beautiful. Now there is Touch ID on it, very reliable and accurate every single time. Not accurate if you touch it with a wet finger, then it won't recognize. Alright, in the design part there is another thing that I have to mention. There is a headphone jack in it. Yes, this was the iPhone before iPhone 7 was released, so this has headphone jack in it. And there is usual lightning cable to charge. So as I talk about the charging, let's talk about the battery life on this phone. This is where this becomes a problem with the other phones or the other medium range phones that are released in 2020. This doesn't give a huge battery life. This doesn't give you around 8 to 9 hours like the other phones or other Android phones or other iPhones in 2020 give, which are damn expensive. But if you're gonna buy this phone at 17,000 rupees and just want to set it as a primary phone, not using it way too much for the games or excessive tasks, then you can get away with 8 hours, because the standby times on iPhone are so much good. Even if you leave the phone overnight, this won't degrade the battery even by 1%. So that's a beautiful thing about iOS. Talking about the battery life, let's talk about the charging for a bit now. This comes with a 5-watt charger. Because the 5 watts charger that this phone comes with will take you 3 hours to fill the battery fully, that is 0 to 100. If you are a gamer, that is the same amount of battery life this phone will give you. Yes, 3 hours for the charging and 3 hours for the battery life is not a good deal. If you compare this phone with the other phones in the 2020, they'll only take 30 to 40 minutes to take you from 0 to 100. There are even phones which only require 22 minutes. So on the battery life, this has a negative point. The point where this has so much positive when compared to the other phones is the camera part. The camera on this phone is magical, is something you wouldn't even complain a single thing about. Now I have a Pixel phone right here. If I compare this camera to the iPhone camera, then the only point where the Pixel disappoints me is the video part, because the video on this phone is so damn good. The processing of the video is so damn good. There is OIS and also it can shoot 1080p at 24, 30, 60 and even 120 frames per second. The slow-mo on this device is 720p at 240 seconds. The camera I'm recording right now is Canon M50 and it can shoot 720p at only 120 frames per second, but this thing is a beast in videography. I even did a mock-up ad with this video on the Canon M50 where I shot the entire b-roll of the camera on this. So that's the best point. I know it's 2020 and you want to take those beautiful portrait pictures or night side pictures. Now this is where the camera lags. There is no portrait or there is no night side, but the normal pictures coming out of this camera is so much good. I know the night part is so damn disappointing, but if you give this phone enough light, then it will take gorgeous pictures for you. Now that we are done with the camera part, let's talk about the software on this phone. This is currently running iOS 13.6.1 and Apple has promised this device iOS 14.2. So the longevity on this phone is around 2 years right now. If you're buying right now, you can get away this phone with easily 2 years of experience. Because Apple will release another iOS update, iOS 15, in the later part of the September in 2022. So 2 years, easy. The apps on this device are beautifully smooth. They are super smooth and super optimized for the iOS on this, and it impresses me every single time. Now, the major point, if you're gonna buy an iPhone 6s Plus in 2020, go ahead with the model that has more than 16 gigs of storage, because the iOS will easily drain up the storage. 1 GB or 2 GB for the software update, and you will remain with only 10 or 11 GB if you are going with the 16 GB variant. And also the main point is, if you compare this storage with the Android storage, that might be a mistake, because PUBG installed on the Pixel or the or any Android device is only 1.9 gig, but this is 2.8 gig. Because the software and the apps are so much huge on the iOS, you should have even 32 gigs in 2020. That's what I'm saying. Now, if you have enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel. And the main note that I have to leave is, this is my opinion and my opinion only. And this is only dependent on my usage of iPhone 6s Plus. That is it for the video. Signing off.